Welcome to Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland, Ohio. It's Friday Night Basketball here on ESPN as we get set for tonight's matchup between the Cleveland Cavaliers and the Washington Wizards. As this one gets underway, what's the game plan here for the Cavs?
You've got to prepare for the backcourt. Everyone knows about the speed of John Wall. What they often don't concentrate on is the greatness of Bradley Beal. The ability to shoot it deep, to attack the rim, to impact the game on the backboard. I love the potential of Bradley Beal.
Boy, when you play Washington, you've got to be ready for one of the best backcourts in the NBA. As a coach, Jeff, how do you handle Wall and Bradley Beal?
A perfect fit together for the Wizards. You talk about Bradley Beal's jump shooting, playing off John Wall's terrific speed and penetration. And then Beal's a good rebounder, and he too is an excellent defender. So they've got it covered at the offensive end and at the defensive end.
He loses it. Good hands. Gets the steal. Smith draws the contact. Yep, it's a foul called against Gortat. That's his first. And J.R. Smith will go to the free throw line. He's shooting 88% on the season.
J.R. Smith to the line, shooting two.
Misses the first. Jeff, John Wall always had the talent, but now he's a pro and a leader with Washington.
He really is. Listen, it was not easy for John Wall. He came into a horrifically bad team, and he persevered through some tough times. And those tough times have made him stronger as a player and as a leader.
Jump shot, Walker. Good finish inside. He's averaging 15 points per game this season. A quick move, gets inside for the layup, able to hit.
That's just a nice layup right there.
To the basket, and he's fouled. Kevin Love picks up his first personal of the night, and Marcin Gortat will go to the line with under a minute and a half to go here in the first. And he connects on the first free throw. Fails to hit them both. Hits the first, misses the second.
Jeff, I know you're a big movie guy. This past offseason, LeBron James acted in some movies. Is he a better actor than a player?
Well, his opponents would say he acts on the floor with some of his fluff, but he's got another profession he's going to be good at. Mike, and doesn't it somewhat make you sick to your stomach that one guy is so good at so many different things?
Love the rebound. And he's averaging 9 boards per game this season. Love on the drive. Irving against Wall. Moskov fires away. Can't hit.
And that's not his shot. He should know better than that.
Wall into the front court. The wide open shot, and Bradley Beal with a bucket from downtown.
Oh, that's a thing of beauty right there. Look at that balance, arc, and follow.
James from downtown in the corner. It'll count if it goes. And that's it for the first quarter. Cleveland's up by one. Stay tuned for more Friday Night NBA present. So a good start to this one. After the first quarter, we begin the second in a fairly tight game. Neither team able to get control.
No, but it was a good tone set by both teams in that they established the way they wanted to play the game here tonight.
We were talking about John Wall earlier, Jeff, and how he's handled his critics. Now, he deserved some of that criticism earlier in his career, but it also motivated him.
If it's just the Twitterazzi of the world out there criticizing you, pay it no mind. You can't have too many voices in your head and play big-time NBA basketball. You got to know who to listen to and who to tune out.
They double him. Lots of room there. The Wizards with the offensive rebound for a second chance opportunity. Turns him away with the block.
And once again, when the ball is up in the air, they're the ones coming down with it. This is the kind of effort that it's great to see.
To the rim, puts it in. 1-point lead for the Cavs. Cleveland's leading Washington by a score of 13 to 12. Beal against Smith. Goes to the goal. He says no, but the ref says foul. Called against Love. That'll be his second personal. And Bradley Beal will go to the line and shoot two. And he hits the first free throw. And Bradley Beal with 7 points.
Gaines, four-time MVP, just one of five players to have won the award that many times. You look at the names he's with, Bill Russell, Wilt Chamberlain, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Michael Jordan. He truly is one of the great players of all time.
Well, there's no questioning that, Mike. I don't care what your top 10 list, or even if you narrowed it down to, quote, the Mount Rushmore of best players in NBA history, he's going to be under consideration. He can be, and maybe already is, the best small forward to ever play this game.
The assist from number 13, Marcin Gortat.
2 minutes gone by in the second. Cleveland's down by three. James from deep in the corner. James's attempt for three. No good. Wall against Irving. To the basket, flips it up, draws the foul. It's called against Love. And Mene will go to the line for a couple of free throws.
Hey, you can't allow easy baskets. You've got to foul these bad free throw shooters, put them to the line, and see if they can earn their points at the charity stripe.
Knocks down the second after he misses the first. James on the drive. Oh, what a great dunk.
A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish with the hammer.
Oh, he beats the defender. Nice move into the paint. Puts it up. Two-pointer won't go.
Hey, that's good offense. Got the ball in deep into the paint, and they just missed.
Irving on the drive. Gets it up for two. Converts on the inside.
2 points.
Wide open for three. So, end of the first half, and we're all tied up. We'll have more Friday Night NBA. Welcome back to the Quicken Loans Arena for the second half of this basketball game. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Cleveland's involved in yet another close game, Jeff. They've got to be very happy with what took place in those first two quarters.
Yeah, tie game. I don't really have a great handle on which team is going to get some separation, but I thought it was a well-played first half by both teams. It'll be interesting to see what develops in the third quarter.
The two-pointer won't go. Wall against Mozgov. Gortat fires. Love the rebound. He's averaging 9 boards per game this season.
And he's been working hard around the rim here today, using his positioning to get the boards.
Misfires on the three. LeBron James is 0 for 3 from three-point territory.
2 minutes left in the third quarter.
call against Irving.
Nobody near him takes the three, and the rebound grabbed by Mozgov.
Boy, there's some incredible point guards these days in the NBA, Jeff. And you look at a guy like Kyrie Irving. Is anybody a better ball handler?
Now listen, he is a special, special player. When he's at the top of the floor, either in transition, one-on-one, or in the high pick and roll. The guy has a unique handle. He can get to any spot on the floor he wants. And his greatness has been obscured prior to LeBron James coming back to Cleveland, because he wasn't playing in any meaningful games. Now, because of James and Kevin Love being there, they're playing in meaningful games, and we're getting to see all of his talents come to the forefront.
James from long distance in the corner, and LeBron James with the jumper for three. He's got 11 points in this matchup.
What a great back-and-forth game we've been watching here today, Mike. It's getting hard to keep count of all the lead changes.
On the reverse, knocks it down for two. The Wizards down by one.
You want to keep attacking the basket and get layups around the rim. That's how you score consistently.
James fires away deep in the corner. James has shot from behind the arc. Won't go. Puts it down.
Oh, that's a sweet finish right there. Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Beal on the drive. Swatted away by Mozgov. Gets to the rim. Third quarter in the books. Cleveland's up by three. We'll have more Friday night NBA. Fourth quarter set to begin. Boy, this one is anybody's game right now, Jeff.
I'm here sitting, and I'm nervous. It is such a hotly contested game. One play could make the difference between winning and losing. Let's see which players can withstand this type of heat and pressure.
Against Irving. Howard dribble with the drop step. Oh, throws it right back at him. He accelerates. Strong to the goal. There's the whistle. Nice job drawing the foul. And Kevin Love will go to the line with under 2.5 minutes to go here in the fourth.
That's really good basketball right there. One of your best free throw shooters draws a foul, now is able to really add on to the lead that they've established in this close game down the stretch.
Oh, he misses the second free throw. He goes 1 for 2. Wall against Irving. To the rim, puts it in. 4-point game. Cleveland's leading Washington by a score of 25-21. Gets it off, knocks it down, and it's a 6-point lead for the Cavaliers. And he curls in on the drive, gets it to go. And John Wall with 6 points.
And this is called turning it up here in the second half with this type of offensive approach, making a much bigger impact on the scoreboard than he did in the first half.
No doubt about it, he hit him. It's called against Gortat. And Kevin Love will go to the line. He's 1 for 2 from the line tonight.
That's good offense. You're leading late in a close game. Get the ball to your best players and to your best free throw shooters, so if they're fouled, you can build on your lead.
So he goes 1 for 2 from the line after hitting the second. Back up, back up, back up.
Wall against Irving. Nice move down the lane.
Right there, and it won't go.
You want to win in this league? You've got to convert your opportunities at the basket.
Inside to the basket. Oh, what a pretty shot from Kevin Love.
Oh, look at the use of the body to create the space to get the ball up and in the basket. Nice job.
Inside. It's good. And John Wall with 8 points.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Puts it up for three. Knocks it down. Beautiful shot from LeBron James.
He's got 14 points in this matchup.
Timeout call. The Wizards down by 8.
Coming out of a timeout in the last minute of the game, many teams would give up in this situation. No, what you have to do is get a quick three. When you knock that in, immediately set up your defensive pressure and try to force a turnover.
Cleveland's made a few substitutions here. A good look for two. Not that time. The two defenders converge. There's the whistle. They had to stop the clock, so they get the foul.
That's his first personal foul. The Wizards are now in the penalty.
First free throw, good. Goes 2 for 2 at the line. Ball knocked loose. Puts it up. Nails it. Half a minute remains in the game. The Cavs up by 8. James against Porter. One of the books. The final score is 38-29. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thanks for joining us and good night.